Cortex XSOAR in a single server deployment. Last time we did one video about how to install Cortex XSOAR on a multi-tenant environment, but for development or installing it in a lab for you to test it out, I think single server deployment will be more practical and it will consume low resources in your machine as well. This one is the official documentation for the installation. This is very useful for you if you need to know the file paths and where does it store different components of the Cortex XSOAR. When we install it today, we will use the default installation, which means everything will go in the root folder. But if you want to implement this in more business critical environment, then it's a good idea to mount them separately because it's more salvageable then. As usual, we will use Ubuntu server for our guest machine to install XSOAR. Let's get started. New machine, give it a name and choose Linux. Scroll down until you find Ubuntu 64. Next, I will give this 5GB RAM, but you can start with 2GB and once you implement some playbooks and integrations, then you can go up as resource consumption climbs. For the space, I would give it around 60GB. Create it. Now we have our disk created here. I'll just put it up. Select Ubuntu 22. I will leave a link in the description for download of the ISO as well. Start it. Try your install. The language, you should select English, layout, Ubuntu server. Be careful with this option because if you choose Ubuntu server minimized, it will be missing some of the packages that XSOAR will be using for the installation. So you will get an error. It can be fixed by downloading it, but if you want more convenient way, just go with the Ubuntu server option. Done. Run. No proxy, mirror address is a default, use the entire disk. Okay, we have mount point, 29GB in the root, and boot has 2GB. Okay, everything looks good. Then let's go done, continue, your name, XSOAR, username, password. You have to choose a password here. Okay, done. Install OpenSSH server, because sometimes we need to transfer files from the host machine for things like that. Done. Don't need anything because XSOAR installation file will download everything that it needs from Docker to everything that it uses. So it's very convenient. Done. Now let's wait until the installation is done. So now the installation is complete. Now we will reboot the server. We need to set the network to bridged, because we need to access this from the host machine itself. So it's easier for us to have a dedicated IP for the XSOAR server. Leave everything as default. Okay. Press enter. Now this will reboot. Sometimes you will face this issue that Ubuntu server is stuck on resolving network address, and when you log into it, it won't have an automatic IP assigned to it. Then you can set one manually, a static IP. Now we have booted into our Ubuntu server. Let's check the space that we have available right now, dfh. Okay. In root we have more than 70% available now. So next step is we have to get the installer file inside the Ubuntu server. You can either use wget or you can use WinSCP like me. I'm using this because already I have downloaded the installer file to my system. As you can see, it's here. We need to know our IP. It's 192.168.1.148. Yeah. Cancel. Okay. 68.1.148. Username. Yes. Okay. Now we can transfer the latest installer file to our machine. If you have a doubt about if something goes wrong or if you need to reset your installation, then this is a good time to take a snapshot of the clean Ubuntu server. Let's see if we receive the file here. Okay. Now first we have to make this an executable. So for that I will use sudo chmod plus x server . This permission is not recommended to have in an executable on a Linux machine, but since we will remove the installer file once we did the installation, it's okay. Because the problem is anyone can execute this file, so this might be a security issue when it comes to Linux. how it's executable. Do sudo to server and press enter. Right now this is on all on default, so it will install it on root directory. Now as you can see, it will pull all the dependencies of the XSOAR by itself. Now it's time for you to get a coffee and wait for installation to finish. So as you can see, XSOAR is asking which port do you want to use for HTTPS. Okay, we will give the default port. Elasticsearch database, nope, we are using Vault database, no. For the convenience, I will just leave the user as admin and I will give it a password. Verifying the password. It seems the complication was not enough. Okay, let me try something else. Verify. Everything seems good. Configuration is correct. Now we wait for some more. Now it will ask for us if we need to start the server or not. By the server, this means the demisto services. Let's say yes. Enabling Cortex XSOAR services. And this is the URL that we will use to access XSOAR using our host machine. So let's check the services. Demisto status. Okay, bit of a mistake there. Fix it. Status. Okay, it's active. So let's try to access the site. 92.168.148. Check why this is not working. Well, the problem we are having was we didn't just use HTTPS. So after using HTTPS, we're good to go. Proceed. Voila. We have our XSOAR instance up and running. We use admin password. try that again. Well, now we have to upload our license. I already have a license, but this one is a little bit odd. So I think I have 10 more days left. Let's check. Same demisto license here. Yeah. Drag and drop it. Here. Yeah. Okay, seems like everything is running. So now we will go to settings. As you can see, the license will expire in 9 days. So rules, things up. As you can see, no account management, that means we are on single tenant. Check setups and everything is there. So you don't have to create any accounts, no hosts, nothing is there. One more tip I can give you, that if you go to settings and advanced backups, you can turn this off. Because here right now our purpose is to just to test some things. It is nothing we cannot restore, so we can just take a snapshot and keep it and reuse that one. Otherwise what will happen is backups will start filling your storage, so we don't need that happening. Let's go back here and we will check our storage after the installation. Yes, edge. Okay, right now we have a little bit less than 50%, but we can work with that. If we need any more space, we can just expand that partition. That's also possible with VirtualBox. Okay guys, that's it for today's video. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for more. We have done a bunch of other videos on XSOAR. I will leave a link to them in the description. If you guys have any suggestions of what kind of content you would like to see in the future, leave a comment and see you guys in the next video.